Market trades higher, though mildly off the day's high. Keen sees gain over 1% each on the back of strong global cues. Zee and Aisha Motors are the top Nifty gainers. Nifty Bank charges ahead, adds over 2.5% as private banks continue their up move after the strong response to Kotak's QIP. Ujjivan shines as lower cost of funds and decline in OPEX aids operating profit growth in the fourth quarter. Some shift in consumer spending as the heat wave and COVID-19 influence consumer choices. Bajaj Electrical says demand for fans is higher, while Blue Star says overall demand is recovering. Metformin manufacturer Lupin, Sun Pharma and Aurobindo are in focus after reports suggest that the US FDA finds high levels of cancer-causing substance NDMA in the diabetes drug metformin. And former World Bank chief economist Kaushik Basu calls for higher fiscal spending, ignoring rating agencies. Says the COVID narrative must change to highlight lower debts in India and to end the lockdown intelligently. Good afternoon. Welcome to Business Lunch. I'm Sumaira Abdi. Well, it's turning out to be quite a good afternoon of trade right now. So about 1.5% higher on the frontline indices. And we had seen a bit of underperformance earlier in the week for India compared to the rest of the globe. Well, the last 2 days, it looks like we have caught up. So we have caught up to pace with the US market and just mildly behind the European markets right now, on track for a 4.5% weekly gain. So for now, it's almost 500 points up on the Sensex, above 32. The Nifty too looks to be closing in on 9,500 right now, doing well on the mid-cap space, and the financial stocks are seeing another great run. So let's talk about some more stocks which are making news, and of course earnings is top of mind. So Dabur is a stock in focus. The stock is up despite a dismal Q4 performance where, you know, volumes disappointed quite significantly. The management has said this morning that they're already seeing some recovery. Mangalam is here with the Street View and to highlight the management comments. Mangalam.
That's right. You know, Sumaira, the results were much lower than what the Street was working with, so which is why we're seeing a lot of price cuts by the brokerages, be it something like Jefferies, where they've cut their EPS estimates by about 2 to 3%. They've pared down their price target on the stock as well. And similar is the case with Credit Suisse as well. They had a price target of close to 500 on the stock, and they've cut their target to around 475 as well. But what stands out is the fact that they both maintain their calls as buy and outperform, and that's because the company is still a strong thematic play. The last couple of quarters, this one and the quarter that we're in right now, would be jarred by the fact that there is the coronavirus pandemic. But post that, the company stands to benefit from increased awareness of immunity, as well as people's preference towards the branded products. So if you take a look at it, the management this morning, while they said that yes, they do see 400 to 450 crores of impact in the first quarter in terms of revenue, May they're back to normal with regards to their sales, almost 80% of normal times. And more than that, you know, they're seeing emerging categories. The management used the word rocking to say the sort of sales that, or the demand that they've seen for their Chyawanprash and honey products. And for sanitizers, which they launched, the hygiene segment, they see sales of almost 100 crores in the first quarter itself. So while the Street was worried about 14.6% volume decline, the management itself is not too concerned about that. And they believe that the company is on course to show good emerging trends, and rural is likely to outperform urban. So all of that is leading to the stock moving higher today.
All right, Mangalam, thanks much. The stock that's moving on the downside is United Spirits. They've reported a weak set of earnings for the fourth quarter. Operating margins are in line on lower employee costs and operating expenses as well. But the outlook for the next year remains uncertain, and this is what is weighing down the stock. Nupur is here with the key highlights. Nupur.
Well, thank you for that. Weak numbers reported by the company. Management indicated that Q4 performance was largely impacted due to COVID-19 related disruption. And all in all, FY20 was a challenging year considering the general election in first quarter and slowdown in economy. On outlook, they indicated that the outlook for the next year remains challenging as well as uncertain. All in all, performance was below expectation. Revenue was down 11%. Gross margin fell by around 400 basis points to 42%. Profit was down by around 76%, but operating margins came in line at 13.6% versus expectation of 13% on lower employee cost as well as other expenses. Volumes were down by around 13.3% versus expectation of 8-9% decline, and under prestige and above segment, volumes were down by around 20%. This segment contributes over 60% to their top line, but from balance sheet, company managed to repay debt by around 600 crores. It came in at just 2000 crores versus 2600 crores same period last year. But do remember, stock trades a slight discount when compared to its peer at just 33 times FY22 expected earnings.
All right, Nupur, thanks much. Also, pharma companies are in focus today. Reports suggest that the US FDA has found elevated levels of carcinogens or cancer-causing material in some versions of the diabetes drug metformin. Ekta is here with the details. Ekta, what are you picking up?
Cancer-causing substance NDMA being present in metformin, which is a very popular diabetes drug, all the way in Feb. But that seems to have settled down in terms of news. But the news seems to have resurfaced on reports as of now that the US FDA has found elevated levels in some versions of the drug. Now, recalls of metformin could be expected as early as this week in the US, according to reports, which are unverified by CNBC TV18. Now, the companies that manufacture metformin, which could likely be impacted in case of such an eventuality, include Lupin, which is one of the largest manufacturers of metformin. Also, other companies include Aurobindo, Sun Pharma, Granules. We spoke to Granules, and they said that, in fact, they've received a notification from the US FDA yesterday itself on metformin, where they said that the US FDA said that the levels or the batches by Granules are acceptable. Remember, 30% of the total sales that Granules produces, 30% comes from metformin itself, and 70 to 75% of those total 30% sales is actually imported or exported into the U.S. So that's the kind of dependence that Granules has. So this would be an important story to watch.
All right, before we take a quick break here, some important news from the global markets. China's National People's Congress has approved the proposal to impose new national security legislation for Hong Kong, paving the way for the law to be finalized and implemented in the city. Remember, protesters in Hong Kong have taken to the streets since last Friday when the legislation was first proposed. The U.S. has also criticized Beijing's move and said that it undermines the freedom and autonomy of Hong Kong. Well, that is the important global news to monitor. But as we slip into a very quick break on Business Lunch, we're going to actually leave you with the commentary that came in from the Dabur management. We referred to it earlier, saying that the stock is higher given the optimism spelled out by the management. Hear them out. We'll be right back.
April was a complete shutdown, and the situation was pretty much like the way we saw in the end of March. But May, we are seeing 80% recovery order. Our Chyawanprash business is actually rocking at the moment, so we are facing complete shortage of stocks, and as we speak, we are ramping up our capacities, and so is the case with honey. Honey is also giving us a growth of around 80%, and we are very bullish about our healthcare portfolio going forward. That, in my view, personally, going forward, it's just a matter of around a month with this exodus happening from urban to rural, around 4 crore people going in there. Because the sheer population base, rural will start growing at a higher clip as compared to urban. Hand sanitizers, we are into surface cleaners, into hard surface cleaners, aerosols, air sanitizers also that we've launched under the brand. And the initial response on market has been pretty good. And we think in this quarter we'll be doing a sales of around 100 crores in the hygiene-related category, which is both home and also personal hygiene. we are not really too concerned about this 14% volume decline because our business is trending very well. We till YTD February were growing at around 6.5%, backed by a volume growth of 6.2%, which was the best of the pack as far as the industry is concerned.